Last night, our health and wellness reporter Sonia Azad shared a candid conversation with four women about why they decided to freeze their eggs. She wanted to talk to them because she was about to go through the process herself. Tonight, Sonia shares her own experience.
So, I want to be a mom. I don't mean right this second, but for a lot of us, a career has come first. I've had so many friends who have gone through the egg freezing process. I couldn't find anything that really took me through step by step. What does it look like to freeze your eggs?
Ready to get the news about your egg reserve?
I am. You're a little nervous at the beginning because you don't really know what to expect. I didn't know anything about my AMH levels.
AMH is a blood test that's used to assess egg reserve. And the good news for you is that you have a good AMH.
Yay!
Yay.
Got a lot of eggs.
So we do the ultrasound.
We'll do the ultrasound.
And that coupled with this will give you, give me a better idea of what's going on.
So between your two ovaries, I'm counting 18 antral follicles. Good number of them we hope will respond to the fertility injections.
Okay.
So that all looks good.
The idea of giving yourself shots is really scary for a lot of people, including myself.
The first medication that you're going to be on is called Menopur, and that's used to help stimulate the ovaries and egg production.
The main thing that you inject every day.
This is the main thing that you'll inject every day.
Yeah. So, and I have to inject it into my stomach?
Uh-huh. So all together, you're going to be on them for about a week and a half, about 10 to 12 days, roughly.
10 or 12 days seems like nothing. Almost every day, I was driving all the way to Bedford from Dallas and back, and that's because doctors are monitoring you extremely closely.
Okay.
So all this tonight.
All those tonight and the following night. So
right.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, then you come back in on the fourth day of drug.
Oh boy. We're about to get personal.
Okay, so I just gave myself my first injection and it was like right here. You can probably see a little bit of bruising. It was not easy.
Nightly injections by myself, mixing vials of medicine. I was really uncertain of what I was doing the first night.
This is second night.
To do that every night.
So you can see what I'm doing here.
I just didn't know how I was gonna get through it.
I think I'm kind of getting the hang of this. Yeah, so tomorrow I have a blood test.
And then you have to get periodic sonograms so that doctors can monitor whether or not your ovaries are growing, how quickly your follicles are growing, and that all is an indication of how successful the process is going to be.
This is a follicle developing on your left ovary.
You're starting to feel shifts and changes in your body.
So today I have to do two shots supposed to prevent me from ovulating.
Everything happened as it should have.
Don't be alarmed, gotta multitask sometimes. Started feeling a little more full today in this region.
It just is uncomfortable in a way that's really hard to express because it's nothing that you can outwardly see, but inside you kind of feel like, whew.
Trigger shot number one. One more in the morning and then that's it.
So you just have to be patient.
I'm about to give myself my last shot. I'm so excited, so excited. This is about to all be a thing of the past. And then I'm going to the doctor to get a final blood test. This is it, this is it.
We'll take good care of her.
Okay, starting to drift off there. The actual egg harvest just takes us 5 or 10 minutes. It's ultrasound guided, a needle will puncture the vaginal wall and enter the ovary.
There we go. Got one from the first follicle.
We drain the follicular fluid from each follicle, and then in the laboratory, the embryologist is looking under the microscope and identifying the eggs.
It went great. She did perfectly. She'll be waking up in just a few minutes.
How are you feeling?
Good.
Yeah,
little crampy, but
that's normal. So we got 13 eggs, a baker's dozen. You sailed through this perfectly.
Okay. Thank you.
All right.
It's ideal to freeze the eggs a couple of hours after the egg retrieval. Once they're frozen in liquid nitrogen, they'll stay there until you're ready to use them. And they look good on first glance.
I have 12 eggs on ice that are viable, and I can thaw them when I'm ready. I still don't know the answer to whether or not I'll even use these eggs. My intent would be to get pregnant naturally, I think. And then this is plan B. And if I never use these eggs, then great. But if I need to use them, at least they're there.
It's all about choices, right? Right now on WFAA.com, you'll find Sonia's blog walking us through her journey day by day. You can also check it out on the WFAA app.